everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing an example of arc length today. And this is arc length in two-dimensional space on an xy coordinate plane of just a regular graph. So we're trying to find the length of a segment of the graph, not to be confused with arc length in three-dimensional space where you're dealing with vectors, planes, helixes, all that kind of stuff. So two-dimensional space for arc length. But the example we're going to be doing today is y equals 2/3 times the quantity x squared plus 1 to the 3/2, and we're going to be evaluating on the range 0 to 2. So we're trying to find the length of the graph between 0 and 2, between x equals 0 and x equals 2. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing that we're going to do is go ahead and take a look at the formula that we're going to be using. The formula for calculating arc length in two-dimensional space is the square root of 1 plus the derivative of the original function f of x squared. And we're going to be evaluating that on a to b, or in other words, 0 to 2. So using this formula, the most complicated piece of it is this f prime of x squared here. So the first thing that we want to do is calculate that piece so that we can just plug it in along with all of our other information. So we'll go ahead and do that. We're going to take the derivative of our original function y, and we're going to need chain rule to do it. The way we're going to take the derivative is using chain rule, and if you're having trouble with chain rule and you need help, please go visit that section of my website. It is a complicated concept, so I'm just going to breeze through it here. But we're going to take the exponent here on this quantity, x squared plus 1, and we're going to multiply it out in front as this 3/2. And then we'll subtract 1 from the 3/2 to get 1/2 here. That's just regular power rule. We leave everything on the inside, x squared plus 1, completely untouched, because that's what the chain rule tells us to do. Take the derivative of the outside, in other words, you know, that exponent, leaving the inside completely untouched. But then to apply chain rule, of course, we have to multiply by the derivative of the inside as well. So the derivative of the inside, x squared plus 1, is 2x, which is why we've multiplied by 2x here. So that's how we take the derivative of that function using chain rule. And then we're going to go ahead and simplify. So you can see that this 2/3 times 3/2, the 2's will cancel, the 3's will cancel, we'll end up with 1 in the front. So we can just move this 2x to the front here, and everything else stays the same. And now we're going to go ahead and square this function, because we're looking for, remember, the derivative of the original function f of x, but squared, as you can see here. So we're going to square it so we can plug in for this whole thing. So when we square it, the 2x becomes 4x squared, and this x squared plus 1 to the 1/2, remember that anything raised to the 1/2 is the same as that thing, is the square root of that thing. So this is the same thing as the square root of x squared plus 1. And realize that, of course, if we square a square root, we're going to end up with that original thing that's inside the square root. So this 1/2 just goes away, and we're left with simply x squared plus 1. So now this 4x squared times the quantity x squared plus 1 is what we're going to plug in up here for this f prime of x squared. So we go ahead and do that. We put it in, and we're also going to apply our parameters 0 to 2, and we're going to plug those in for a and b to our original formula. So once we've done that, we can go ahead and start simplifying what's inside the square root. So we distribute this 4x squared among the x squared plus 1. We multiply that out, and we get 1 plus 4x to the 4 plus 4x squared. And if we rearrange those terms, we realize that we can factor, right? If you change this to 4x to the 4 plus 4x squared plus 1, you just put the plus 1 at the end, you can factor that into 2x squared plus 1 times 2x squared plus 1, or in other words, the quantity 2x squared plus 1 squared. So that's how this breaks down as a factor. So then, of course, if we're taking the square root of something that's squared, we're just going to end up with the original, right? This the square root of the squared means that this squared here will go away, as will the square root, and we're just left with this 2x squared plus 1 here. So now we've gotten to a point where we can actually take the integral, And then once we do, we'll evaluate from 0 to 2. So taking the integral, really basic, we add 1 to the exponent to get 3 here, and then divide the coefficient 2 by the new exponent, 3. So we get 2/3 times x cubed, and then the integral of 1 is x. And that's our integral, so now we're going to evaluate on the range 0 to 2. So to do that, remember when you're evaluating a definite integral, that's what this is, of course, because we have a range from A to B. And if you have trouble with definite integrals, I have that section up on my website as well, so please go check that out. But remember with definite integrals, we always plug in the top number first, and then always subtract, and then plug in the bottom number. So you can see that we've plugged in 2 to our entire function here, and then we subtracted here in the middle, and then plugged in the bottom number, which is 0 in our case. So now all we have to do is simplify, and if you simplify this, 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, so we've got 8 times 2/3 plus 2 gives us 16/3 plus 2, and everything in the second half here is going to become 0. This whole thing here is going to go away. So we're just left with this 16/3 plus 2 from the first half of our evaluation here. And so now we just need to combine these fractions. If we get a common denominator, we have to multiply this 2 by 3 over 3 so that we get 6 over 3, and we can combine these two fractions using this common denominator of 3. And we get our final answer of s equals 22 over 3. So the length of the curve in two-dimensional space, the length of the graph between 0 and 2 is 22/3. And that's our final answer. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!